In this video, I'm gonna teach you everything you need to know about the modalverb wollen, how to conjugate it, in which situations do you use it, and what's the difference between möchten and wollen. Viel Spaß! Hallo, guten Tag! Ich hoffe, es geht euch gut. First of all, thank you very, very much. Vielen herzlichen Dank. My channel has now over 1,000 subscribers and I'm amazed how fast this went. And I really just want to thank you for all your support, for all your likes, for all your shares and comments, especially the comments. I always love to read them. And yeah, thank you very much. I'm so grateful and this is really something that keeps me going. All your feedback, and I hope I can make many, many more videos for you guys. Alright, but in this video, we're gonna talk about the Modalverben. Wir haben 6 Modalverben, which are können, mögen, wollen, sollen, und müssen. Können und mögen, we have done already. In case you haven't seen those video, I'm gonna put a link down in the description of this video. But in this video, it's all about the Modalverb wollen. Wollen is to want. Wir fangen an mit der Konjugation. We start with the conjugation. Infinitiv wollen. Ich will, du willst, er, sie, es will, wir wollen, ihr wollt und sie wollen. Wir haben 4 Situationen, where we can use Modalverb wollen. 4 different situations where we can use it. Nummer 1 ist Wunsch oder Wille. Der Wunsch, der Wille, Wunsch ist wish und Wille ist will. Zum Beispiel, sie will eine neue Stelle finden. She wants to get a new job. She wants to find a new job position. Sie will eine neue Stelle finden. Oder sie wollen bald heiraten. Sie wollen bald heiraten. They want to marry soon. Oder Hans will Pilot werden. Hans will Pilot werden. Hans wants to become a pilot. This is a very common question, especially when you're young or as a kid. It's like the question, what do you want to become? Was willst du werden? What do you want to become once you grow up, once you're older? And then you can answer this by saying, ich will blah 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 dream job werden. And you see here, as normal for modal verbs, and you only conjugate das Modalverb, you only conjugate the modal verb, and at the last position, always at the end of the sentence, there is the second verb in infinitive, in the original form, meaning you don't touch it. It's just there and it's always at the end. It doesn't matter if it's a question or if it's a statement, always put it at the end. Nummer 2 ist Absicht, die Absicht oder der Plan. Absicht is intention, Plan is a plan. Zum Beispiel, ich will jeden Tag 5 Wörter lernen. Ich will jeden Tag 5 Wörter lernen. I want to learn 5 words every day. This is actually a good number in case you're learning any other languages or especially for German, of course, as well. 5 words every day or 5 days a week is enough, way enough. This is quite a good number to improve your vocabulary. Oder, warum willst du Deutsch lernen? Warum willst du Deutsch lernen? This is probably a question you have heard once you started learning German. Maybe you told it to your friends and family, hey, I'm gonna learn German. And then there's the question, warum? Why do you want to learn German? Nummer 3, wir wollen nach Italien fahren. Wir wollen nach Italien fahren. We want to go to Italy. And you see here, this fahren is usually to drive, right? To drive or ride, also ride a motorbike. And here it's actually just go. So it also has this meaning of just going somewhere, to go. Nummer 3, die Situation 3 ist sich weigern. Sich weigern ist to refuse, to say no to something. And you see here on top, and das ist weigern, immer wollen plus Negation. Das ist wollen plus negation, so it's a negative thing. Zum Beispiel, der Junge will nicht in die Schule gehen. Der Junge will nicht in die Schule gehen, the boy doesn't want to go to school. Oder wir wollen kein Gemüse essen. Wir wollen kein Gemüse essen, we don't want to eat vegetables. Oder ich will nichts mehr hören. Ich will nichts mehr hören. This is a sentence I heard quite a lot when I was a child. Of course, coming from my mom, huh, when she kind of upset and she was almost there before she exploded, then she said this, ich will nichts mehr hören, I don't want to hear anything anymore. And then it was silence, Stille. Nummer 4, wollen kann auch ein Vollverb sein. Wollen can also be a main verb. And you see here again this, das ist usually when we use the sentence das, and das ist that. Zum Beispiel, sie will, dass ich die Hausaufgaben mache. Sie will, dass ich die Hausaufgaben mache. She wants me to do the homework. Literally translated, she wants that I do the homework. Oder wir wollen, dass du etwas singst. Wir wollen, dass du etwas singst. We want you to sing something. Oder er will nicht, dass du gehst. Er will nicht, dass du gehst. He doesn't want you to leave. He doesn't want you to go. He doesn't want that you are leaving. And you see here, we have in the first example, we have the subject sie, which is she, and we have ich, which is a different subject. So this whole thing, wollen as a main verb, is only possible if you have two different subjects. Also again for the second sentence, and wir wollen, dass du singst. Wir, first subject, first sentence, and then das du is the second subject. Or er will nicht, dass du gehst. Again, two different subjects. Or there's another situation where we also use wollen as a main verb, kind of main verb. Er will nach Hause. Er will nach Hause. He wants to go home. He wants to go home. So actually we have this verb gehen. At the end there will be this verb gehen. Er will nach Hause gehen. This would be the complete sentence. But if it's so obvious out of the context, then we actually often drop this second verb. We often drop the infinitive. Oder willst du einen Kaffee? Willst du einen Kaffee? Do you want to have a coffee? Actually, in English, also say, do you want a coffee? And so you also drop it. So the verb will be haben. Complete sentence will be, willst du einen Kaffee haben? But we drop this verb and it just becomes, willst du einen Kaffee? Oder das Mädchen will keine Pizza. Das Mädchen will keine Pizza. The girl doesn't want pizza. Again, the verb will be haben. Das Mädchen will keine Pizza haben. Drop haben and then it's completely fine as well. Bonus-Tipp! Wollen versus möchten. Very similar meaning, but it's used in different situations. Zum Beispiel, er will nach Hause oder er möchte nach Hause. Er will is he wants to go home. Er möchte is he would like to go home. So you see here, this möchten is actually just a politer way to express or to use the verb wollen. Wollen ist stärker, aber nicht höflich. Wollen is stronger, it's stronger, but it's not polite. Höflich ist polite. Und möchten ist schwächer, aber höflich. And möchten is weaker, but it's more polite. Zum Beispiel, anderes Beispiel. Mama, ich will einen Lutscher. Mama, ich will einen Lutscher. Das Kind sagt zur Mutter, Mom, I want to have a lollipop. Lutscher, are these guys here. Better would be, Mama, ich möchte einen Lutscher. I would like to have. Or even better, you add this bitte. Mama, ich möchte einen Lutscher, bitte. So in this situation, it's kind of okay, it's kind of accept, because it's quite common. Kids use wollen quite often because they somehow realize that this wollen is much stronger, and if they want to achieve something, if they want to have something, then maybe they're more lucky by using wollen instead of möchten. This is for kids. For adults, don't use this wollen, except if you really want to emphasize, if you want to emphasize something, if you want to express it really in a strong way. For example, as a boss, and you want your employee to do it right now, then you can use it. But don't use it if you are talking to strangers, people you don't know, and especially if you ask for something, especially in the restaurants. If you say, ich will einen Kaffee, to the waiter, then you might not get one, maybe. Or if you get one, he is definitely angry with you, so he will look at you in a strange way. Always, when you order something, try to use möchten. Ich möchte einen Kaffee, bitte. I would like to have a coffee, please. And then you will get your coffee right away, no problem. Hausaufgabe, now it's your turn. The question is, warum lernst du Deutsch? Warum lernst du Deutsch? Why are you learning German? To answer this question, you can, of course, use the verb wollen. Or you can also say, make a sentence like, I learned German because, with weil, also very useful. Let me know down in the comments why you are learning German. I'm really interested to see your comments. I'm really interested to know why you guys are learning German. Vielen Dank fürs Zuschauen. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked this video. I hope you learned something. And I hope to see you soon in one of my next videos. Here, right here, this video is all about the next Modalverb in this series, so you can continue watching and learn everything about the other verbs as well. Hope to see you soon. Bis dann. Auf Wiedersehen. Tschüss und bye-bye.